In this video, we're gonna discuss how Big Picture and Jira supports scaled Agile framework planning. So we'll look into how program increment and iteration planning looks like. If you're working in SAFe, we'll discuss why you should consider Big Picture for doing that. And if you're not working with SAFe, I'm gonna cover what kind of benefits this approach gives you and why you should consider that kind of planning for your Agile work. This is part of our efforts to provide you best possible training around Jira, Big Picture and whole Atlassian ecosystem. If you would like to support us, like the video, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment below if you have any further questions. And remember, you can always reach out to us for one of our paid services like trainings, consultations or implementation. So let's take it away. I will be showing this you on these particular boxes. So over here we have our SAFe Agile release train, and below that we have two program increments that I will be using as examples, and two iterations inside one of the program increments. I will show you how to use those based on planning. But you can already see that to use this type of planning, we actually need lower level boxes, program increments, type and iteration boxes to do that. And if you're not familiar with SAFe, ART is basically, as I mentioned, Agile release train. This is group of teams that is delivering particular piece of software, let's say. But if this is not approach that you're using in your company, very often I've seen this box being large project or large program. We can still do planning in that kind of approach on lower level, on program increments and iterations. We've seen that used in multiple companies with multiple customers. I had success using that kind of approach. So you do not have to be working in pure SAFe to actually use that approach and get benefit from it. So I would encourage you to still consider this approach, and as I think it brings a lot of benefit. Okay, so to actually perform our planning, we will go to the board module in our SAFe ART. And over here, we'll be doing the planning. So in this module on the left side, you can see that we have our lower level boxes, which at the moment is our program increments. On the right side, we have our whole backlog with tickets, with Jira issues that are currently identified and we want to deliver. And you can see over here that at the moment we are able to do the planning just on program increment level, but we can drill down and do plannings on lower levels, that is iterations. So what is the idea? The iteration is basically a sprint. So if you're working in Scrum, this is basically one-to-one with sprint, time-boxed period of time where you are, you know, where your teams are deciding that, okay, we'll deliver this amount of work in, let's say, 2 weeks. And after 2 weeks, it should be ready to be delivered. Now, program increment, as it suggests over here, even with hierarchy, is a higher level element. It's still time box, so the concept is really similar, but usually it covers like 8 to 12 weeks. So it can be even 3 months. And over here, we're doing high level planning. Right, so first we are doing the planning on program increments on those high level elements, for example, epics, saying that, okay, in this program increment, we deliver this epic so that later on we can drill down and do more precise planning for each iteration. What it allows us to have or to give, because there is several benefits of having this higher level boxes and doing this high-level planning on the program increment level. So the main benefit of using these higher-level boxes in planning is that, of course, we have a longer-term plan. Agile assumes that, yeah, we want to plan only for a brief period of time because it allows us to be agile. But But for a lot of companies, this is really not feasible. Some companies need to know that specific piece of software or specific feature will be delivered, for example, in next 6 months, and they need to allocate resources for that. So this is what these higher level elements allow us to do, with still keeping flexibility, because on lower level boxes, on program on iteration boxes, we just know on very high level what we want to deliver. More on that in a moment. But on iteration level, we still have flexibility saying what we are delivering in this iteration, in the next iteration, and later on, you know, we do not have to declare exactly what will be delivered. Time for that will come. So this approach allows to merge this more long-term planning and long-term view of both what will be delivered and how our resources look like, with keeping a lot of flexibility from standard Scrum approach and standard sprint planning. So if you ever had a situation where your team working in Scrum had your iteration nicely planned and management asked you to tell, hey, when will we deliver this, asking about the project that is like 3, 6, or 12 months long, you weren't really able to tell them the answer because, hey, we just planned next 2 weeks, this approach may be helpful to you and help you solve the problems with this longer term view that higher management might require. Okay, so let's have a look actually how to do the planning. So normally, first, of course, you're doing program planning on program increment level. And usually over here, we are planning high level elements, like over here, I planned issue type phase, which is basically an epic. So we can take from our list of things to be delivered from our backlog, epic, and just drag and drop it. You can see that not only we can drag it to specific program increment, but also we have a team swim lanes. So we can have over here multiple teams and assign epic right away to this team. So I'm talking about epics because usually those higher level elements are being planned here. And we are basically saying that, okay, in this program increment, we deliver this epic. But of course, if there are some lower level tasks that are already defined and that are maybe urgent because we identified dependency with something else, we would like to deliver specific story without delivering whole epic in given program increment, we could plan it in the program increment too. So there's a lot of flexibility. You can see that things that were planned automatically get highlighted over here in green, so we know that they are already planned. Usually, those elements should be estimated in some way, right? So on epic level, we could do story point estimate, for example. It will be very rough. Of course, there might be a lot of story points on the epic, but it's basically for the same reason as we're doing that on the sprint or iteration level. We want to have rough idea of on how much time it will take and how much work we can take in for given program increment. Now, what is great and what is one of the coolest, well, not the coolest, but one of the biggest benefits over standard Jira boards in planning, because technically we could create Jira boards that represents or where we're doing program increment planning, is that over here we can see dependencies. We can create them and we can see dependencies between different issues. So right away we can see whether issues are planned in a proper order, because if they wouldn't, the dependency right away would be highlighted either yellow if they are planned for the same time box, indicating that there is some risk that if we deliver this too late, we won't be able to deliver this, or even red if we just plan it in the wrong order. So this is first thing. And second thing, we see on a single screen things that each team has to deliver with dependencies going across teams. So over here, we are actually able to point out to the teams that, hey, you need to talk about these tasks because there is dependency between tasks that you're delivering and tasks from other team. This very often I see is a pain point for a lot of customers. For some reason, work that is being delivered within single team, the teams are able to handle dependencies with no problems. But the moment there is dependency going across teams, suddenly it's like people are not able to communicate anymore. So this simple information, this simple view of containing dependency, which on normal Jira boards is not available, to get dependency over there, we would have to enter the issue and see what is inside, what are the issue links. This single views helps us to increase transparency a lot and basically allows us to facilitate communication between the teams. Okay, let's go down and have a look at what we're doing on the iteration level. Right, so on initiative level, the idea overall looks the same. So on the right, we have our backlog. We can show all the tasks or only the ones that are planned on the higher level, right? So if we would do planning like pulling Epic with all identified tasks into given program increment, over here we could narrow down so we see only them. I prefer to see whole backlog and look at this like that. So we see that this Epic is planned for our program increment. We see this over here. So we start pulling the tasks that are part of this Epic into one or the other iterations. Of course, teams will be doing that depending on how many story points they want to commit to in each iteration. For each iteration, we are able to, at the moment I'm displaying work progress, but we are able to see capacity allocation. So basically we are able to track capacity of the teams and how many story points for each iterations are assigned to this team. So at the moment, yeah, I have nothing assigned to the team. There is one thing that is assigned to unknown team, the team that is not defined in my box. Let's quickly assign something to team blue and we'll see that, yeah, there is a progress of capacity allocation. So on this screen, we can not only do the planning, track dependencies because they work the same way as in program increment, but also keep track whether the team is overallocated or not. And later on when iteration starts, we can check what is the progress. So how many story points were already delivered. Okay, but now the question appears. Oh, sorry, and of course, there is an option because we did just high level planning on Epic level. We may have some lower level elements identified or not. But in general, if team sees that they need to deliver some Epic, they may as well create tasks over here. Because of course, maybe they just identified additional piece of work that has to be delivered to create the Epic. Maybe we really, when planning the Epic, did not have work breakdown structure of lower level elements done yet. So this is also possible that we will plan Epic that currently on PI level that currently has nothing below, and then we'll start creating specific tasks over here to make sure that we deliver this Epic. Okay, but now the important question is, if the iterations are meant to be like Scrum sprints, then why should we use that? Can't we just use Jira boards with sprints? If yes, then how it would work with this one? If no, do our team have to switch completely to big picture? The good news is that you can still use Jira boards and sprints over there. These iterations can be completely synced with Jira boards and sprints over there. So let me give you an example. Okay, over here. So I'm in project, that is basically a scope of my safe art. And you can see over here I have sprints. So basically what I can do is I can plan task over here for one or the other sprint. Currently I have two defined. So this is P011. If I do this planning over here, in the moment, we'll see that this task will appear as planned for this iteration over here. So I'll hit refresh and we will see that this task appears over here. So there is two-way synchronization between that. If we plan something on the iteration over here, it appears in our Jira board sprint. And if team plans something in Jira board sprint, it will appear over here. So teams could actually use Jira boards as they are doing this now without basically any change. We could use this screen just as an overview. So there are two things that I want to mention. So first of all, I would encourage you to use this screen anyway, especially if you have work where there is a lot of dependencies between teams, because here you will see those dependencies. This is always a benefit. It allows to avoid so many problems and get rid of so many headaches that I cannot even describe it. But if there is a case that your teams are not really do not have really a lot of dependencies between them, then teams can do the planning on their board. You will have overview over here. So that's pretty cool. Second thing I want to mention is that the setup for this, in our experience, can be a bit tricky. So this really depends on what is your current setups for boards, for sprints and for teams, right? If all the teams are using single board with single set of sprints, this is one case, but you may have different boards for different teams, or single board with multiple sprints for each team separately, and of course, mix of all those. So the good news is that BigPicture can handle it all, so there is no problem there, but the configuration on how to make sure that all the boxes are synchronized correctly with iterations and teams might be a bit tricky. So if you have any doubts over there, let us know. We will help you. Okay, so that would be it for this video. Of course, there could be a lot said about other things around this. So for example, how to set this up for situations where we have part of the work delivered in the waterfall manner and we want to see overview of everything. Big picture can do that too. Or how to set up different program increments for different projects. If this seems interesting to you and you want to know more, you can check our other videos on the channel. There is quite a lot about that. Or you can reach out to us to discuss your specific case. And other than that, it will be everything for this one. Hope you enjoyed it and hope it was useful. See you in the next video.